It causes wear and tear of running parts, such as machine parts, soles of shoes, etc., which may damage the materials. You might have seen the wear on steps of a foot over bridge at the railway station. This occurs due to friction created by the shoes of people who use these steps all the time. That is why the edges of the steps are covered with metal coverings to avoid wearing of steps of foot over bridges. Another important consequence of friction is the production of heat. Energy is wasted in the form of heat in overcoming the frictional force. Frictional force converts kinetic energy into heat energy. This causes the heating and wearing of the surfaces in contact. Due to this unwanted heat produced in the machine, cooling arrangements have to be made to avoid damage. That is why cars and other vehicles have a separate cooling system. Do you know how a matchstick catches fire when rubbed against a rough surface? Well, when a matchstick is rubbed against a rough surface, heat is generated due to friction. This heat increases the temperature of the matchstick. Now, when the temperature of the matchstick becomes sufficiently high, the matchstick catches fire. Similarly, when two pieces of dry wood are rubbed together, they catch fire. In jungles, massive fires occur due to such rubbing of branches of trees. Excess of friction can cause sliding of a heavy object across the floor. Difficult. Let us do a quick check. Friction cannot be eliminated. It can only be reduced. In certain situations, it is desirable to reduce friction. Friction is caused by rough surfaces. It can be reduced by any process that makes the surface smooth. For example, while playing a game of carrom, you need to sprinkle fine powder on the board to make the surface smoother. As a result, the frictional force between the surface of the board and the striker is reduced, and it becomes easy to play the game. Use of lubricants. Friction results in wear and tear of the machines. That is why we use oil, grease, or graphite paste to minimize friction. These substances are called as lubricants. Lubricants are applied to the moving parts of the machine. It fills the minute uneven spaces present between the two surfaces, forming a thin layer between them. Hence, the two surfaces do not directly rub against each other. This reduces friction and improves the efficiency of the machines. We oil our bicycles regularly to reduce the frictional force between its parts. As a result, it becomes easy for us to ride the bicycle. Sometimes, we hear a rattling sound when we open or close doors and windows. In such cases, oil the hinges. It reduces the friction and makes the doors and windows move smoothly. Use of ball bearings and wheels, that is, rollers. Ball bearings are small metallic spheres used to reduce friction between the shaft and the hubs of a machine. The ball bearings consist of small steel balls present between the steel surfaces and can roll free. They are designed in such a way that the moving parts of the machine roll over each other rather than slide over one another. The balls act as rollers between the axle and the inside surface of the wheel, thereby reducing friction. In a bicycle, a ball bearing is used between the hubs, that is the center, and the axle of the bicycle. This makes cycling easier. Ball bearings are mostly used in between the hub and axle of a ceiling fan. You might have experienced that it is difficult to drive a heavy suitcase. This is because the sliding friction between the suitcase and the ground is more. However, if we fit the same suitcase to the wheels, it becomes easy to drive the suitcase. This is because the sliding friction is converted to rolling friction. Therefore, use of wheels between the two surfaces moving over each other reduces friction. That is why often the luggage bags are fitted with wheels, that is rollers, to allow them to get pulled easily. Wheels are used in bicycles and other conveyances like a car to make their movement fast and easy. Use of air cushions. In certain cases, for example, in a hovercraft, lubricants cannot be used to reduce friction. A hovercraft is a vehicle that is capable of traveling over different surfaces such as a swamp, sea, or a land. In a hovercraft, an air cushion is used. An air cushion separates the two surfaces and does not allow the moving object to come in contact with the other surfaces. In this way, friction is reduced. By polishing. Polishing reduces the roughness of a surface, thereby decreasing the friction. The tires of a racing car are made smooth. This reduces the friction between the tires and the roads, enabling them to move faster. This type of tires are called as slicks. Using anti-friction material. Some special materials, for example, Teflon offers a low friction. Now, Teflon is considered to be the most slippery substance in existence. It is for this reason that Teflon is used in non-stick frying pans. Let us do a quick check. Methods of increasing friction. Friction is desirable at some places. We can increase the frictional force to suit our purpose. This can be done by making the surfaces of the objects rough accordingly. For example, soles of the shoes are grooved. When a long and hollow depression or cut is made on the surface of an object, it is said to be grooved. Soles of shoes are grooved to increase friction between the soles and ground, thereby providing a better grip. Similarly, the soles of an athlete's shoes contain spikes on them to provide a better grip. You might have seen designs on the surface of a tile. These are called treads. It helps to increase the friction between the tires and the road. This prevents the tires from slipping on a wet road, thereby avoiding accidents. You might have seen the game of kabaddi. While playing, the players rub their hands with soil for a better grip of their opponents. Similarly, gymnasts apply some coarse substance on their hands to increase friction. This provides them a better grip. You might have seen a car getting stuck in mud. On such occasions, we notice that even though the wheels turn, the car does not move forward. Then, what is done to get the car out of mud? A wooden plank is placed under the wheels to increase the frictional force. As a result, the wheels come out of the mud easily. We find ramps or slopes built on railway stations. These ramps have a rough surface. The surface has been deliberately roughened so that we do not slip while walking on them. Let us do a quick check. What is fluid friction? Substances that are capable of flowing and can easily change their shape are called fluids. For example, liquids such as water, juice, and oil, and gases like hydrogen, air, etc. are all termed as fluids. Fluids exert frictional force on objects moving through them. This force is called fluid friction or drag. It refers to the force which acts on a solid object due to its interaction and contact with the fluid. The air resistance force experienced by a car or an aeroplane when they move at higher speeds, and the water resistance force experienced by a speedboat moving rapidly in the sea are some of the typical examples of drag. Drag force acts in a direction opposite to the direction of motion of the object. Drag comes into play due to difference in the velocity between the solid object and the fluid. When the solid object comes in contact, factors affecting fluid friction. The magnitude of frictional force on drag exerted by a fluid on objects depends on four factors: speed of the object, shape of the object, size of the object, and nature or viscosity of the fluid. Drag force acting on an object moving through fluid increase with the increase in velocity of the object. Due to drag, movable bodies lose their energy. That is why an oscillating pendulum slows down and then comes to rest after some time. Drag also depends on the size of an object. For example, the drag force experienced by a moving bicycle is much less as compared to a moving truck. Larger the size of an object, greater will be the drag force acting on it. Drag also depends on the viscosity or the nature of a fluid. For example, air is less viscous as compared to water. Hence, an object will experience more friction or drag in water as compared to air. Disadvantages of fluid friction. Some of the disadvantages of fluid friction are: it reduces the speed of an object moving through the fluid by opposing its motion. When an object moves through a fluid, it loses some of its energy in overcoming the fluid friction. This decreases the efficiency. For example, a moving car uses some part of its energy, that is petrol, to overcome the air resistance which opposes its motion. In order to reduce the loss of energy, that is fuel, efforts are made to minimize the fluid friction. Methods of reducing fluid friction. Activity. Let us perform an activity to understand that the shape of an object has a significant effect on the drag acting on that object. Take an A4 sized paper. Crumple the paper into a ball and throw it in an upward direction with some angle. What do you observe? You observe that the paper falls down quickly. Now, take another A4 sized paper and fold it in the shape of an airplane. Hold this paper, the airplane, in such a way that its wings are upside. Now, throw this paper plane upwards with some angle. What do you observe? This time, the paper airplane flies for a while and falls down, crashing. What can you infer from this activity? Well, the shape of an object has a significant effect on the drag acting on that object. A streamlined shaped object experiences less resistance from the fluid. A streamlined shape is narrow in the front and broader at the back, thus increasing the speed and ease of movement of the object. The fluid friction can be reduced by giving streamlined shape to the objects which move through fluids like air or water. A streamlined object can move with high speed and push the fluids on its way. Hence, cars are designed with streamlined shape to reduce the air resistance. Birds also have a streamlined body which helps them to fly easily. Similarly, the aeroplanes are designed in a streamlined shape to reduce air resistance. You might have seen fish of different shapes and sizes in the market. If you observe them carefully, you will notice that they have a streamlined body. This allows them to move easily in the water. Let us do